Larry's mother, Sandra, says her son was doing so well at the state psychiatric hospital, they were making plans for his supervised release. But in the last phone conversation they had before he disappeared, she says her 48-year-old son sounded down. Now he's gone and off his some 16 medications. His family is gravely concerned for Eldridge's safety and well-being.
And I just don't want people to think he's some kind of a killer.
Larry Eldridge comes from a large, loving family, four siblings and parents that love him and want him back.
I just want people to know that he's not a threat to society, that he is not going to hurt anybody.
Larry's mother bristles at the depictions of her son in the media flurry after he failed to return from a furlough from the state psychiatric hospital April 30th. Sandra Eldridge says the reason her son was given furlough days to leave the grounds and be independent and conquered is that he was doing extremely well and that the medical regime was stabilizing his personality.
I love that hospital. They gave us back a wonderful young man.
Eldridge is a diabetic and suffers from seizures. His family tells News 9 he suffered a brain injury in a construction accident in 2001 when a gable crashed into the front of his head, changing his personality and compromising his short-term memory. He was sent to the state hospital after being found incompetent to stand trial in a criminal restraint case and has failed to return on furloughs twice before. Now Governor Lynch calling for an investigation into how the hospital decides to furlough patients. The restraint case was from 2009 when Eldridge's wife said he held her and her children against their will for 10 days, terrorizing them. And she says she's in fear that he's now out, unsupervised. She also claimed to News 9 that Eldridge raped her, but he was never charged with sexual assault. The Eldridge family wants the record straight, and they have this message for Larry.
Call somebody, call one of us, and let's get you back to where you need to go.
Larry doesn't have a cell phone or a car or any money. His family says he hasn't made any contact with them at all, and they are most worried about him having severe seizures now that he's been off his meds for 2 weeks. They're praying that if he is found, he will be treated humanely and brought back to Concord for treatment. Live in the studio, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.